if you have selected the appropriate configuration on the computer and boot from this USB stick. Then you see a screen where there are several options. Normally it is enough to confirm the first pre-selected option to start Linux. However, if there are problems with the startup, then there are still settings in the other options to change certain things. In most cases this is not necessary. So let's start by confirming the first option and let the computer start with Linux. Depending on what kind of PC you are using, it may take a few minutes for Linux to load completely. After that you should see a screen with a flower background and an installation icon that we can click on. Once the installation has started we can select a keyboard configuration. The default is the American language. But since I am from Germany, I need a German keyboard configuration. Therefore, I click on the plus sign and select the German keyboard. Depending on the device type, there are also different variations which we don't need here. The next step of the installation is to choose how the hard disk should be used. In my case, the decision is quite easy because I use only one hard disk. But if you use other hard disks, USB sticks or SD cards in your device, then you should look here twice before you decide for the ROM choice, because we want to avoid choosing the ROM hard disk and override it by mistake. I use the option with the complete hard disk. This means that the previous operating system is completely removed from the hard disk and the whole hard disk is prepared for Linux. If you don't want to do it this way and make a few more settings, you can also use two operating systems on the same hard disk side by side. This is then a so-called dual boot configuration. After we have made our choice, we continue with the next screen. There it is shown that we want to install the so-called bootloader for Linux and Windows systems on our hard disk as well. The selection I made called MBR stands for motherboard record. In most cases this should work. The next step of the installation is to name the computer. I have chosen the name MX1. Later on I want to create more copies of the system created here and they will get names like MX2 or MX3. We leave the computer domain and the workgroup as they are. It is important to check the box for Samba if we want to use file systems that are normally used under Windows. After clicking next we go to the configuration of the time settings. These settings are quite self-explanatory and can be configured as desired. In addition, the choices made here can be adjusted at any time later after installation. The next installation step revolves around configuring the user account. Here we select a name for the username and a password that is as complex as possible. In addition, we can add a checkmark for the so-called root password, with which we can later make critical settings that normal users are not allowed to change. If you want, you can also set a checkmark for auto login. This will start the operating system directly with the user created above without having to enter the credentials. The last checkmark on this installation screen determines if we want to apply any changes we may have made before the installation. The last step in our installation process is the indication that the installation is complete and our computer can be restarted after the installation is finished. Once you see this screen, you can click Finish and your computer should restart with the Linux system you just installed. To avoid a restart of the installation process, the USB stick will be removed before the restart. If you are using a computer that does not support USB sticks, you have to remove the installation CD. Okay? That was it so far with the installation. If you have any questions or suggestions about the content of this video, just send us an email. We always answer ourselves and usually within 24 hours. If you want to build your own Algo trading system farm, then subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you need faster or better results in algorithmic trading, then maybe check out the premium course on our website. For now, thank you for your attention and we'll see you in the next video.